The self-sufficient life, a life that is lived as independently as possible from any entity other than yourself for your basic needs and subsistence. I started this video series out talking about analyzing your life, talking about the power and starting. The first three videos were primarily motivational videos. I want to get into this one on a couple of mechanics, you know, the way I see it. We're going to start out this time with research. You've got to research for the self-sufficient life. You've got to learn new things. Most people watching this video are already doing a lot of things, but we can always improve and do more research. We can always expand into other areas. We can modify things to make them more efficient, and research can do it. I would like to suggest a long forgotten item that seems to have all but disappeared in this technological age, and that's books. I got one here. You know, I'm talking mostly about gardens. Well, this time, this is that, oh, I'm sorry, it's upside down. This one is a book. It was a book that I started out with in the Carpenter's Apprenticeship Program many, many years ago. This is a very good reference book and covers many, many areas of carpentry. It can show you the basics of what you need to know to build anything. Now, I'm not saying that you can go out and build a huge condominium, but you can learn basic stuff to take care of different things. But books, research, don't just research, collect them. If you can't collect, get out to the library and try to research. YouTube is a great resource, but you know, while it's great, there is still a personal touch lacking with being able to touch something. I mean, even smell it. I mean, I love the way a book smells myself. I love books. But, you know, research and collect that. Build a library. Next thing is networking. You need, YouTube is a great networking place. But, you once again, you need the personal touch. You need to search out people in your own communities, because you need that support, the physical support with each other. I see a lot of people on YouTube. They're, man, wonderful people, but I can't tell if they're hooked up in their community with others. And you need that personal touch. And you see, one person has one skill, another person has another. No, you complement each other. It's a symbiotic relationship. The next is organize. Organize yourselves. You know, they used to say that an untidy desk is the sign of an untidy mind. And I found in my case it's true. Right now my desk has got a lot of stuff on it from me working today. But I've found something that when my desk is untidy, I don't think very well. But so organize yourselves. You know, if you've got a tool room, you know, is it organized or is it just thrown in there? You know, if it's organized, you can work more efficiently, you can work more quickly. And it gives you better time to be able to think on the things that you need to think of. You need to organize your thoughts. You need to organize with other people, events. You got to be able to organize your gardens, organize your skills. Think about what you're doing that needs to be organized. That is, I have found to be, and my experience, something that a lot of people lack. Even myself, is I am, ask my wife, I'm a highly organized person. I hate disorganization. It will send me through the roof to see something disorganized. But, because, you know, if something's disorganized, then I got to take the time to organize it so I can do what I need to do. Get yourself organized. So that's it for this one. Research, network, organize. Another thing on the networking, being self-sufficient doesn't mean that we're lone wolves. We need each other. Self-sufficient people can't do everything. They can do a lot of things and they can get by. But, we talked about a quality of life. When you network with other like-minded people, a better quality for all around comes into being. Now, I'm going to be moving into some other things in the next few videos that I hope you'll stick around and look. I'm having a hard time organizing my own thoughts on this. There might be some people think I'm nuts, but I want to be talking about why I feel it is so important to live a self-sufficient life. And I'm not just talking about, so you can have what you need and supplying yourself some things. I'll get further into it. I got to get my thoughts organized better on it so I can present it well. But living a self-sufficient life is a lot more important than people are realizing. Good talking with you. You guys have a good day.